Hello students, today we shall learn something about line and staff structure in an organization. So what is line and staff? Line and staff are names given to different types of functions in an organization. Both these terms are originated in military organizations. A line function is one that directly advances an organization in its core work. That means whatever is the direct functions of an organization. For example, if a business organization is engaged in sales, right? So sales is the direct function, or if it is a manufacturing concern, so production of goods or services is the direct function. So whatever is the core function of the organization, a line personnel, whosoever are responsible for doing those activities, constitute the line function. For example, production and sales are line functions. A staff function supports the organization with specialized advisory and support functions. For example, if a production department is installing a new production technique, and if any expert advice is needed regarding that, so a staff function shall be there to support and to provide that specialized service needed for the production of production with the new technique. Okay, so the examples of the staff function are the services of the legal department are considered to be the staff function. So we can see here that the line function is here is board of directors, and below them are the managing director, and below managing director are functioning the managing director of manager of division A. Maybe it may be a production department, manager of division B. It may be a purchase department, manager of division C. It may be a sales department. Some other departments may be there, like manager of division D, which is a marketing department. So all these functions constitute to be the line function. These the line that is being drawn straight here constitute the line function. And while functioning, if the managing director needs certain expert advice, then he may take the services of the, say, while recruiting a expert person, he can take the services of human resource manager, or see if organizing a certain specific training programs, if he needs the services of human resource department. So human resource manager shall be the staff personnel. Or during the functioning of the company or the organization, if he needs some legal advice, so he may seek the legal personnel, the legal expert who may advise him about the legalities of certain issues, and that constitute the staff function. Similarly, the financial advisors, while raising any kind of a fund for any particular product or activity, managing director may seek the advice of the financial advisor, and there may be the assistants to managing director who are working for the managing director at different times. So the human resource manager, the legal advisors, the financial advisors, the assistants to managing director, they may advise him in his functioning, and his functioning comes under the line function because he is also responsible for the activities of the organization. So this chart help you understand what is the line function and what is the staff function. So in a line organization, top management has complete control and the chain of command is clear and simple. For example, line organization in small businesses in which the top manager, which may often call him as the owner of the organization, maybe the sole proprietorship, is positioned as the at the top of the organizational structure and has clear lines of distinction between him and his subordinates. The staff is attached to the line to assist or to support the line in discharging its duties efficiently during the course of the functioning of the organization. The line and staff organization combines the line organization with staff departments that support and advise the line departments. Most medium and large sized firms exhibit line and staff organizational structures. While both hierarchies have their own chains of command, a line manager may have direct control over staff employees, but a staff manager may have no such power over the line employees. So please mark the distinction here that both have their own chains of command, the line organization and the staff personnel. They both have their own hierarchy of commands, but a line manager has the direct control over the staff personnel, but the staff manager may not have direct control over the line employees. Okay, so the staff manager or the personnel at the controlling authority at staff in staff line may not have powers to issue direct orders to the line personnel. Okay. In modern practice, what we see is the difference in the two hierarchies is not so clear cut, and jobs often have elements of both types of functions. So if we come to the line structure, let's find out what is the line structure. So line structure consists of direct vertical relationship, which connects the position and task of each level with those above it and below it. It represents a structure in direct virtual relationship through which authority travels. A line position is directly involved in the day-to-day operations of the organization, such as producing or selling a product or service. So line positions are occupied by line personnel and line managers. So line managers are those personnel who are having the authority of controlling the line positions or line personnel below their in their span of control. Line personnel carry out the primary activities of the business, very important, and are considered essential to the basic functioning of the organization. Okay, if line personnel are not there, so the basic functioning of the organization will not be operated. An example of a line manager is a marketing executive who may see involved in the promotion of the product. So marketing executive, the functioning of the marketing executive is the line personnel. Line structure. Okay, so line positions, whether they are personnel or managers, engage in the activities that are functionally and directly related to the principal workflow of an organization. So now we see what are the advantages of the line structure. Clear-cut relationships. We find the clear-cut hierarchical structure of the position, who is reporting to whom and who is supervising whom. The clear-cut relationship is there, okay? And there is unity of command. Unity of command means the person or the personnel working in the line structure will be receiving instructions from one and only one boss. Prompt decision making. Since the hierarchical structure is clear-cut defined, the powers and authorities and responsibilities are clear-cut defined, so decision making is quick, and effective coordination is there among the line personnel. Fixed responsibility. Since the structure of the authority and responsibility are clearly defined, so everyone's responsibility is fixed, and there is discipline in the line functioning. Okay. See, there is no such any organizational structure which is free from all the limitations. So line structure is also having certain kind of limitations or disadvantages. Let's see what are these. Difficulty in staffing. In line functioning, the authority and responsibility structures are so clearly defined. At times, there is difficulty in staffing also. Concentration of authority, the controlling positions are having the authority, maybe the absolute authority over the staff working under them. So there is concentration of authority in this structure. The orders, the personnel has to follow the orders of the boss in an absolute manner. So there is concentration of authority. Lack of specialization, since line functions are considered with the day-to-day functioning of the organization, so there is lack of specialization. They may not have the specialized skills of performing the jobs. Instability, there is the structures are not so very permanent, so there is instability in powers of the controlling authority may be given to someone else at times, and there is no such fixed structure that the persons who are holding the positions who are working in a line may not be changed. Okay. There is poor motivation level, because the orders or the instructions are to be followed. As such, there is full discipline in this line authority. So the motivation level of the employees is not very high. Ineffective communication, because the orders flow from the above positions. So the communication from the upward communication, that is from the lower level employees to the higher authority, is not very effective in this type of a structure. Not useful for larger enterprises. This line structure is not very successful for the larger enterprises. Now let's see something about the staff type of structure. Person of organizations who provide advice and services to the line personnel are the staff organization. Okay, so they are the experts of their field. They provide these advices. At times it is needed by the line function for proper functioning of their activities. They provide expert advice on important matters such as finance, such as human resource, the sales, the promotional policy. They enable line people to work more efficiently. Okay. Staff positions serve the organization by indirectly supporting line functions. So staff positions are not involved in the direct functioning of the organization, but they provide the line functions to perform in an efficient manner, and so they are providing the support services to them, and so they are indirectly supporting the line functions. Staff positions consist of staff personnel and staff managers. Staff personnel use their technical expertise to assist line personnel and aid top management in various business activities. Staff managers provide support, advice, and knowledge to other individuals in the chain of command. Although staff managers are not the part of chain of command related to the direct production of goods or services, they do have authority over personnel. But they cannot directly issue orders to the subordinates in line departments. An example of a staff manager is a legal advisor. So what are the advantages of a staff organization? The main advantage is the specialization. See, the staff personnel are experts of their field. They are appointed there due to their expertise. Okay. So they help in the growth and expansion of the organization with their specialized services. The burden on the line executives shall be reduced with their proper advice and help. The decisions may be taken in a better manner because the expert advice is there. So decisions are more informed and more, we can say, the quality of decisions is better. Training of line executives this is the also the advantages of staff organization. This is the advantage of a staff organization that they help in the training of line executives, whatever specialization they are lacking, whatever specific skills they are lacking, that may be given as a training to the line executives. And in this whole activity, staff organization may be very helpful. And staff organization help in the advancement of research. As we know, no organization can grow without adequate amount of research. They have to improve their quality day by day. And in that area, staff organization will be very helpful. Staff organization also suffer from some limitations. The disadvantages of this staff structure are as follows. Different orientation. See, they are very, whatever their view is about any problem, anything is very different. They go deep into the problem areas and analyze them. So their orientation about anything is very different from the line executives. Conflict between line and staff. See, the staff organization is there, is created to help the line personnel, but it is observed that there is often there are chances of conflict between the line and staff. Lack of responsibility. See, staff organization, staff personnel are not directly performing the activities of the organization. So they are not having direct responsibility of anything. Lack of coordination. See, they are not in the hierarchical chain of command. So the coordination among the staff and the line is a little bit difficult. Excessive reliance on staff. It is observed that at times the staff are there to help the line functional, line personnel to function, but at times they rely excessively on staff. This structure is costly since the appointment of a staff involves the experts or the specialized personnel to be there to help the line functional functions. This may be involving huge expenses on their salary and all that. What are the responsibilities of line and staff managers? The line managers are responsible for the formulation of objectives, plans, and policies since they are directly involved in the functioning of the organization. Decision making regarding the implementation of plans and policies and attainment of objectives, providing supervision and leadership, achieving coordination, and exercising proper control over the activities. The staff managers at the same time are responsible for advising, helping, and guiding the line managers in the performance of above functions. They provide specified administrative services if needed. They interpret the objectives, plans, and policies. They make available the best tools for the implementation of plans and policies. They help in the selection and training of employees, and they also help and devise proper tools for measuring the organizational effectiveness. Line and staff may have conflict at times. So what are the reasons for that? Line and staff relationship is based on the assumption that both support each other and work harmoniously to achieve organizational objectives. However, It is seen frequently that there is conflict between the line and staff in the organization. This generates lots of friction and loss of time, and consequently loss of organizational effectiveness. So there is a need for analyzing the sources of line and staff conflict and the measures to tackle those conflict areas and to overcome the problem of conflict. These relations are often characterized more by the conflict than the cooperation. Staff specialists complain that line managers are resistant to their ideas. See, whenever there is any problem and staff's help is being sought, and when they advise something, they suggest something, the line managers often are resistant to those ideas, and the line managers complain that the staff managers are giving those the advice, the suggestions, which are not very compatible with the field situation, with the practical situation. So they are sky gazing specialists with no comprehension of the practical situations, and often their suggestions are very far away from the practical reality. When we point out the reasons for line staff conflict, we have to see what is the attitude of the line personnel and how these conflict areas are, what are the conflict areas and how these conflict areas appear. So the approach of line personnel towards the staff can be studied as, line personnel deal with the organization as a whole, and therefore they are highly protective of the organization. That means they are also responsible for the activities of the organization, as they are directly involved in the functioning of the organization. So they have protective attitude towards the organization. Since they are ultimately responsible for the organizational decisions, so whenever they are being faced with a problem, they want simple and easy solutions to solve the organizational problems. They often have a short-sighted approach towards the organizational problems because they want the quick fix solution then and there. If any problem is there in their functioning, they seek the advice of the support staff and want them to give them the quick solution so then they can proceed further in their activities. And on the contrary, the staff are specialized, they have the expert opinion, so they go deep into the problem areas. Okay, so they are highly action oriented and want immediate and easy solutions to the problems, and they feel that staff personnel lack experience to work in the functional areas, to work on the ground reality. Okay, so what is the approach of a staff personnel? They are specialists in their areas of experience. They do not view the organization as a whole. So because they are dealing with this specific problem areas, so they not have this whole picture into their mind, and they are often critical of the organization that this is lacking in the organization, this should be done like this, and there is some problem in this particular activity plan, and they study the problem in depth before any recommendations and arrive at all the possible solutions to the problem, analyze their advantages and limitations, and arrive at the most feasible solution. And this whole process may take certain times, and whereas the line personnel need the quick advices, on the contrary, the specialized persons, the staff, they go deep into the problem areas and they study the whole problem and analyze the whole problem and consider the all the possible solutions, and they compare all the solutions and then arrive at the best one. So they offer solutions which line managers feel are complicated to be implemented. Their approach towards the problem is often far-sighted and has a long-range orientation. They do not seek the quick fix method of solution. They study the problem in deep, and they are far-sighted that in future, no such problem shall be there, and find the solution for the one time. They are accused of giving wrong answers as they do not relate these answers to the overall organization structure. This is the feeling that the staff personnel are having towards the line organization people. They are highly analytical, thought-provoking, and have a far-sighted approach towards the problem, and therefore arrive at solutions after spending enough time in studying and analyzing the problem. They feel that line managers do not try new ideas and prefer to work with the existing knowledge. And the feeling is that the line personnel are often resistant to the new ideas, the new researches, the new methods, and they want to work whatever they know, whatever the techniques they are using, they want to go with that only. So I have make a comparative of what are the various reasons for line staff conflict. If we see from the point of view of line personnel, conflict is created because staff personnel often tend to encroach the line authority. They do not give sound advice in the views of line personnel. And whenever any problem is solved, whenever any solution is implemented, they steal whole credit for the success of it. They do not inform the line personnel about their activities, like how they are doing, how they are analyzing the problem. They do not inform the line personnel about it. And they do not see the whole picture because they are specialists. They deal in the specific areas. So they lack this whole, seeing the whole picture. And from the point of view of staff personnel, conflict is created because line personnel do not make proper use of staff personnel. They often seek their advice when the problem is very aggravated. They resist the new ideas. That means the line personnel resist the new ideas given by the support staff. They refuse to give staff personnel enough authority to do their jobs. So how we can resolve these conflict areas? The following measures can improve the line and staff relationships. The clear understanding of the authority responsibility structure will help in knowing whatever the authorities and whatever the powers and the responsibilities of the line structure, and what are the authorities and the responsibilities of the staff structure. If both of them are being counseled and being informed about their authorities and responsibilities, then there are the chances of conflict are reduced. A timely assistance. See, both of them should be counseled about that. Line personnel should seek the advice of this staff on timely basis. That is, whenever the problem arises, they should seek the advice of the support staff, so that support staff have sufficient time, enough time to think over the problem and analyze the different aspects. And by that time, the activities may not get halted for the longer period of time. So timely assistance should be sought by the line personnel, and at the same time, timely assistance should be provided by the support staff also. Emphasis on interdependence. They do not see both the line and the staff personnel do not see each other as competitors or competing for their own positions and authorities. Rather, they should have the feeling that they are interdependent on each other. See, staff is there only for the line personnel for their smooth functioning. So they should be aware of that, and they should realize that both of them are interdependent in their approach. Patient hearing. Whenever there is a problem, then both of them should be very patiently hearing each other's point of views. Now, whenever there is a problem, when line staff or line members are having any problem, when they seek the help of support staff, the support staff should give a patient hearing to their problems, and vice versa. Communication, they must go for clear-cut communicative lines. Whatever staff is doing should be communicated to the line personnel, each other activities, how they are seeking the, how they are analyzing the problem, what work they are doing should be communicated to the line personnel, to the line managers. And line managers also should keep them informed about the activities, when and where their advice, the advice of the support staff can be taken. This is all be communicated to the support staff. One thing should be clear to the staff and the line personnel that the complete task of studying the problem, listing alternative solutions, their effect on the organizational activities, methods of implementation, acceptance of those who are likely to be affected by the implementation of suggested recommendations, suggesting ways to overcome the problems in implementation, these all activities are to be done by the staff. This should be made clear to the line personnel. This should be made to the clear to the staff personnel that whenever there is a problem, the whole responsibility of analyzing the problem and suggesting the ways and implementing the ways and seeing that whatever problems are there in implementing those suggestions shall be tackled by the staff only. Okay. Tolerance. They should be more tolerant to each other's existence because both of them are there for the smooth functioning of each other, okay, each other's activities. So they should be more tolerant to each other's point of views and should have a mature, you can say, behavior towards each other's activities, towards each other's point of views. The one more point of, see, whenever there is a problem, one more method that can be taken to resolve the conflict is through committees. So whenever there is a problem which is to be solved, so more often committees can be formed to tackle those problems in which both types of personnel are there. Line personnel shall be there and staff personnel shall be there, and they both have to work in team to tackle that problem. So one way of resolving the conflict is through committees. Appreciate each other's viewpoint. So they must be, see, mature enough to appreciate if any different opinion is there. So they must be mature enough to appreciate each other's point of view. Okay. And line managers should be educated about the activities of the staff, their specialized skills. So they must be made aware that staff personnel are having the expert skills. They are having the specialized knowledge of their field, so they can better help them in their day-to-day functioning. So this is all about line and staff structures. Thank you all.